Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to ThinkView, and this is Sanity. You still remember this thing, right? It's the ROG Xbox Ally X, and when it's first launched, it runs the special operating system that tried to be Xbox, hence the name Xbox in the name of the product. But in its core, it's still Windows. The special thing about this Windows version is that it's highly optimized for gaming handheld with a very controller-friendly interface and much more console-like experience. And at that point, I think to myself, why don't we install this operating system into a normal Windows PC, or even better, a gaming laptop? Because after all, this is a gaming machine, isn't it? So why don't we further optimize this with a gaming OS? And that's exactly what I did. I installed this customized Windows build onto this Gigabyte A16, and honestly, it's worked extremely well. And after trying it for quite some time, I think that this is a very interesting operating system to try. So that's why in today's video, I will share you all of my experience with it. Now, let's get started. You see, my most favorite thing about this Windows build is its booting time. Normally, Windows take around 10 to 15 seconds to boot up, but with this version, it's roughly half of that. It feels noticeably snappier. Of course, it's not instantly or seamlessly like what I'm used to with an Xbox, but at least I don't have to feel like I'm waiting it for boot up anymore. Now, once Windows fully load, instead of showing the traditional Windows desktop, it automatically launched the Xbox interface. And this interface is fully optimized for controller, so you can easily to navigate to any section using just your controller. And because of that, if you have any PC in your living room that mainly set up as a gaming device, you can consider installing this Windows build. The next time you want to play a game, all you need to do is turn the PC on, grab the controller, and boom! You don't have to wait and use your keyboard or mouse anymore. Now here is one of the coolest things about this version of Windows. The Xbox interface that you are seeing is the default theme. But with just some simple step, you can have your regular Windows back. All you need to do is press and hold this Xbox button. Then you navigate down here. Beside the Xbox full screen mode, there is also a Windows desktop option. When you switch to Windows desktop, the system behaves exactly like a normal Windows laptop. And then you can do most of the things that you want to, like office work, like editing, or browsing the webs. Interestingly, when you switch to this desktop mode, some startup apps and background services that was previously hidden will begin to appear. This means that with the full screen mode, the system is clearly prioritizing gaming first and completely turn off the traditional Windows processes. Only when you need it, you will be able to turn it on. And I think that this is extremely neat because who would need Microsoft Teams or Recall running in the background when you're playing Call of Duty, right? And that's exactly what I want to share with you. As you can see, the biggest advantage of this Windows build is flexibility. You can sit back and play games in the console-like experience, but when you need to get some work done, you can instantly switch back to a familiar Windows desktop. All of that is just an Xbox button away. And since this is still Windows at its core, it supports pretty much every games out there, unlike SteamOS or BioSiOS, which just mainly supports Steam library. Also, when you are already in the Windows desktop mode and want to switch back to the Xbox full screen mode, all you need to do is press the Xbox button again or use the shortcut Windows G. A pop-up will appear. You now have two options, either jump straight back into the Xbox interface or restart the system to further optimize the performance. If you jump straight back to the Xbox interface, well, no performance is lost because all the Windows process that running is still keep running in the background. The latter option we need you to restart in order to terminate completely most of the unnecessary process for gaming. And the result is that you can save up to around 2 GB of memories. Now, I will talk more in detail with the Xbox full screen interface. To navigate around the apps that you already opened, you hold this Xbox button, and then it will show up a multitasking windows. In this menu, you can use the LB and RB button to navigate around, And when you want to choose something, you press the A button. Or if you want to close something, you press the X button. Now, if you press the Xbox button just once, a quick access layout will pop up. From here, again, you can use the LB and RB button to switch between the different section and feature. Everything here is fully controllable with the gamepad, which feels very intuitive. From your screen brightness to the volume level, or if you want to enable some widget, or you want to access the task manager to see how much RAM is eaten up, or probably you want to access some AI feature for gaming, all can be accessed and turned on just from your controller. Now, when it comes to gaming, all of the games that you once installed on your PC will now appear all of it in the Xbox interface. From your Steam, EA, Ubisoft, or even like Riot games, and especially Xbox games are all shown in one place. If you want to choose anything, just select the game you want, press the button, and start playing. How easy is that? And that is most of my experience with the Xbox full screen mode. What is your thought with this special Windows build? Is it superior? Is it better? Would you prefer this Windows version rather than your SteamOS or BazOS? Let me know in the comment section down below, okay? Now, thanks for watching. This is NK for ThinkView, and see you guys next time.